On this episode of Spotlight, we light up your world with larger-than-life lanterns, and we sit down with a local magician who's truly the first of his kind. Don't go anywhere, this is Spotlight. Hello everyone and welcome to Spotlight, where we bring you all things entertainment. I'm Kayleen Talens.
I'm Annabelle Rocha.
And I'm Giselle De Los Reyes.
The weather outside is frightful, but the tea is so delightful. Get ready, it's time for the tea of the day. All right, I don't know about you ladies, but I love tacos. Here in Las Vegas, there's a unique taco shop called Bruno's Taco Bar. This place serves tacos, fried churros with ice cream, nachos, and drinks for those that are 21 and over. But This place has a little twist. Bruno's Taco Bar also has lattes, but lattes that you can customize. You can print any type of image on your latte, and some have put artists such as Drake, Tupac, or even logos, and I most definitely want to try it.
That is so cool.
So, yeah, they have logos. They have like, you could customize anything. You could tell them, or they have like a machine where you could pick it out, or you could just put anything you want. And I want to go.
Let's go. It's Mexican food. I'm Mexican. I love it, obviously. And I have coffee every day.
But
you know that's my type
of
place.
It's perfect for you.
Perfect for Annabelle. So we all got to go there now.
Yeah.
And she would put Chance the Rapper
on hers. I was thinking while you were saying
can
it.
Can you do that?
Who would I put on my latte?
You can. And then you would put...
Ooh, Brendan Urie
from Panic.
Panic at the Disco.
We need to go. Isn't that cool though? Customized latte on foam, and then it says it's like really good for Instagram pictures.
Yeah.
So I want to go. Tacos and lattes. Let's go.
Let's go. Another new place we could check out. So New York's famous Madison Square Garden is coming to Las Vegas and claims it will bring concerts into the 21st century. The MSG Sphere will have internet access and direct audio at each seat. The 18,000-seat venue will be built near the Venetian and Wynn with plans to open in 2020.
Oh my God.
Doesn't that look amazing?
That was pretty.
And, I mean, you can see, like, your favorite artist there, and I guess the sound comes to your seat. So rather than hearing it from, like, a faraway speaker, even though that's pretty loud, like, you'll get, I guess, like, surround
sound.
So
it's going to be even louder.
A whole different kind of experience.
It's a whole different kind of experience.
And it's in 2020? That's actually pretty soon if you think about it.
Yeah, it'll probably happen fast.
It'll bring a lot more people to Vegas for sure after that. Oh by Madison Square Garden, right?
Mm-hmm. And I thought of you because you go to concerts
all
the time. So
that's
like,
so catch me there in 2020 when it opens.
Every single event, Giselle's going to be there.
And I can bring you guys with me.
Let's go.
So whoever comes through, so we'll see.
We go.
It'll be interesting. But now, since we wait for that, it's time to kick off our Here For It. So Las Vegas is already home to two zip lines, one at the Rio Hotel and Casino and another one at Fremont. But the Link will be constructing the first ever zip line on the Strip. It will go from the High Roller to the Link Promenade Hotel. Here for it or not here for it?
I'm here for it.
Ooh. But scared.
Wait. I'm terrified of heights, if you didn't know that about me. I can't do roller coasters.
I wonder how high it's
going
to be. It's like you're like 1,000 feet off the ground. So.
I'm still here for it.
You've done some crazy things, though.
I have.
You've done in the Philippines?
In the Philippines, I went bike zip line.
That looks so scary. Like when she showed us.
Oh my gosh. It was the scariest thing. But I'm down. Let's do it.
So she'll go there and I'll watch.
You'll support.
I'll watch. So while we wait for that to come through on the Strip, the perfect place to fulfill your sweet tooth would be at the Venetian Hotel and Casino. Mm. Black Tap is a restaurant that recently opened and is typically known for their burgers and especially for their crazy shakes.
Crazy shakes like
so what you're looking at is their Bam Bam Shake.
Ooh,
it's blended with Fruity Pebbles, Rice Krispie Treats, and just like a whole bunch of whipped cream, pretty much. All my favorite things. So would you guys be here for it or not here for it?
Who would not be here for that, Giselle?
That looks delicious.
Some people don't have a sweet tooth like that, but
that's
I know Kayleen is the biggest one. I'm not,
I don't know about Annabelle.
It depends what it is, but that sounds good.
That's all my favorite things in one.
They have to have chocolate.
The prices are pretty pricey. It's like $15 a shake, but... it looks really cool, so.
You gotta do it for the gram.
You gotta
do it, gotta do it for the gram.
I would like one shake, please, just for a picture.
True. So moving on to some national entertainment, Marvel Studios is making some history with their newest movie, Black Panther. Not only is it Marvel's first film with an African-American director, but it is the largest opening for an African-American director ever, with an estimated $201.8 million for its opening. Whether you have seen it or not, here for it and not here for it.
So here for it. I saw it yesterday. Wakanda Forever. Am I right?
I haven't seen it yet.
Oh, can't relate, but Wakanda Forever.
I'm so here for it.
Wakanda Forever. It's so good though, you have to see it.
Chad Boseman and Michael B. Jordan make such a great duo.
What's up?
Even though they're against each other, it's definitely worth the watch.
So oh my gosh.
Please watch it.
I will. So I will. Good.
So my last here for it actually might make one of you really happy. And because iHeartRadio is hosting their annual music awards that will air live on March 11th. And one of the biggest awards of the night is their Innovator Award, celebrating artists who contribute to both the music industry and to the community. And guess who is this year's recipient?
Who, Joselle?
None other than your boy, Chance the Rapper.
Let's go, Annabelle.
Here for it.
Let's go, Annabelle.
You know I was here for it.
I already know. You brought it up earlier.
Mm-hmm. I did bring it up earlier when we were talking.
From your hometown. Mm-hmm. So how does that feel that Chance is being recognized
crazy,
like this?
That's crazy because it's like he's around my age. We grew up on the south side of Chicago, just like, you know, just a random kid, you know, had to go through all these things. And like, look how far he's come. Mm-hmm. It's just crazy. And it's so
inspiring.
Nice to see. It's so inspiring. And all the good things he does for the city and just the world in general. I love it.
Maybe you could go get him a latte with his face on it.
Yes.
Right? You guys know what else I'm here for? Celebrating the different cultures here in the Valley. China Lights is a light festival where anyone and everyone can appreciate and embrace Chinese culture, art, and breathtaking lights. I went to see the event to see what it's all about. If you want to see beautiful, colorful lights followed by Chinese culture, China Lights is the place to be.
China Lights is about the Chinese Lantern Festival. We're celebrating the Chinese New Year here, and it's our first time in Nevada. For this festival, we have 40 sets of larger-than-life light displays. It is a time that we celebrate the Chinese culture and art.
Not only are there beautiful lights to look at, but this event has a purpose that is dedicated to Chinese culture.
We see it as a platform to share the Chinese culture and the Chinese history with people from different backgrounds and all over the world.
China Lights is not your ordinary light festival. There are multiple hands needed in order to bring this event to life.
We actually have 18 artisans who are from this city called Zigong from Sichuan province, and that's the city where all the lantern artisans are from and where the lantern making skills in China is best preserved. And then we have 18 of them to come here and set up the show and install all the lanterns. But the whole production of the show actually started 3-4 months ago in China. So everything you see here were made and shipped from China, except for the dragon, which is built here on site in Craig Ranch Regional Park.
Clyde Hernandez, a Las Vegas local, explains why he likes this event.
I like the lights and how everything is so unique. There's no duplicate of a single set. You know, everything has its own characteristics and how the Chinese culture is portrayed. And all that comes combined into like a unique educational experience for everyone here in Vegas.
If you weren't able to make it to the China Lights Festival this year, no worries because they are most definitely coming back next year. For Spotlight, I'm Kayleen Talents.
Thank you, Kayleen. While the China Lights may not be back for another year, one local magician is sure here to stay. Santiago Miquel is the illusionist behind the strip's first Spanish-only show, Illusion Mental. Thank you for being here. I know I said your last name wrong. I'm sorry. So tell us a little bit about how you got into doing illusions. Like, who inspired you, or how did that come to be?
Well, I was six years old. My mm-hmm. parents brought me a magician to my birthday party, and then at the end of the show, he brings the birthday kid to the stage. So he got me on stage. I performed a trick with him where I appear a rabbit out of a hat. It's something very simple, but after that, I thought it was the coolest thing I ever saw, and from there I just knew that I wanted to be a magician. So, 17 years later, I'm here. I have a show on the strip. It's the first Spanish-speaking show on the strip,
yeah.
And it's a dream come true, to be honest.
How did that come to be? Like, were you trying to pitch yourself, or did someone approach you about that?
First, like the background story. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm from Mexico City, and I got to Vegas because I knew I had to go to college. Like, I wanted to like have an education. I knew I had to be educated, because the more educated you are, the better you are as a person, as a performer mm-hmm. in life, the more success you're gonna have. So I knew that also I wanted to have a show in Vegas, so UNLV was the best option for me,
right.
Because it provided
makes
both.
Sense.
And I just like started keeping up with my performance, knocking doors, and then someone gave me the opportunity to have a show here, and we're making the most out of it.
And how's it been going so far for you?
So far, it's good, doing very good, very, very good. We opened on December 28th. We had our soft opening. And then our grand opening was February 7th. Mm-hmm. And we invited the media. We had like grand major opening. And so far it's been like a blast. It's super busy, a lot more time than I anticipated.
Yeah.
But it's doing very, very well.
And why was it important for you to have a Spanish speaking show?
Well, everything in Vegas, there's anywhere between 60 to 90 shows a day. And when you're trying to get into Vegas, there's a lot of competition, so you have to come up with something different. At the same time, it made sense for me because most of my performances are in Spanish, that's my native speaking language. Mm-hmm. So we did a market study, in part with help with UNLV, with Professor Bo Bernhardt, and we realized that there was between 6 and 9 million people a year that came to Vegas that just speak Spanish, and there's no entertainment for them. So we saw a market opportunity, and we're mm-hmm. taking the most. We're making the most out of it.
And would you say that you have to know Spanish to enjoy your show?
I mean, it's a plus, obviously, but I try to accommodate people that don't speak Spanish. Mm-hmm. Every show, like, there's some people that don't speak Spanish, and I do something. I'm not gonna say what, but I do something that makes me realize right away at the beginning of the show if they speak Spanish or not.
Okay.
And I try to involve them. You don't need to know Spanish, but that's a plus. Mm-hmm. There's been a couple of shows that I have had people that don't speak English or Spanish.
Oh,
I'm
wow.
I'm not sure what they're doing there, but I hope that they had fun. I have no way of communicating, but they right. were laughing, so I guess they were having fun.
So it's for everyone?
Yeah, for everyone, for all ages. You'll be students especially.
And this is your beginning. Where do you hope to go with your illusions and
well,
your shows?
Well, it's not the beginning. I have performed in a lot of countries before Vegas, mm-hmm. and during summer breaks, before I even came to Vegas. I arrived to Vegas when I was 21 years old. I'm 24 now. Mm-hmm. So in the meantime, like, I have performed in other places. I mean, I don't know. I'm enjoying it so much. This is like the only thing I ever thought about doing. Mm-hmm. I don't know what I'm going next, but I'll make sure you find out about it. We're gonna make a lot of waves. We're gonna make a lot of headlines about it.
And as a UNLV student, what's it like being a student during the day and then going and performing on the Strip?
Again, it's more time than I ever thought it was gonna be. There's not too much sleep, to be honest. There's nothing too fancy about it. It's a 100-hour job a week. Because, mm-hmm. I mean, the show is kind of the easy part to do. The hard thing is promoting
the work behind it,
getting people to know about the show. Because, again, we have a lot of competition against other people, mm-hmm. against other shows. So the biggest asset, again, is me putting on the time and trying to reach out to different audiences, trying to try different things. And then at the same time, like, this is my last semester at UNLV, so I have to finish.
Right.
Like, I promised my mom that I was going to finish. so it's been very, very hard. But at the same time, like, there's a lot of time, like, in between. So if I could just say it in one sentence, no sleep. That will be the answer.
Well, that's all the time that we have for today. Thank you so much for stopping by. You can see Santiago in action at Planet Hollywood, but right now he'll be giving us a special preview. Check it out.
Well, thank you very much for the invite, and I want to try something that I'm practicing ever since I moved to Vegas, and it has to do a little bit with gambling, so
ooh,
I'm going to need
okay.
someone.
That,
you look like you like to gamble. This is something that I'm still trying to do in a casino, so
okay.
I don't know if I still can do it in a casino, but I'm going to try with you. So we're going to play with dice. I'm going to ask you, while she does this, you're going to cover my eyes.
Okay.
By the way, I don't have anything on my ears, right?
None. Nothing.
Nothing. They're clean.
We're okay. good to go.
I'm going to give you these dice, okay. and I want you to just shake it a little bit. Shake
right
it. You got to shake it.
Shake
and then,
it.
Like,
okay.
Just like get to a number, and then you
covering
close.
Covering his eyes.
Covering your eyes. You can press harder.
Oh, don't want to hurt
okay.
you.
Okay, like, and then like you got a number, and you just look at it, okay? Got it?
Yes.
Okay, concentrate on that number. And I'm gonna tell you, this is like an exercise that you concentrate this number trying to project me. Usually people start with number one. Is that number one?
Yes.
Okay. Just like, that's usually the way people start. So just like change it to like a number you actually wanna think about and just put it on your hand. By the way, you can press harder. It doesn't matter, okay?
Shake it again.
Or you can just put a number that
you wanna think about.
And just put it. You got it? Let me know.
Yes.
Okay, concentrate on this number. And then I'm not sure if this is the case, but usually when people start from number one, they go to another odd number. And I'm getting the feeling that you moved to number three.
Yeah.
This? Can you show the camera?
Yes, I did. Okay, okay.
One more time. Just think about a new number. Just think about a number. You don't have to shake it. Just put that number, and then you can press again really hard.
Are you sure you're covering his eyes?
I am. I don't want to hurt him.
You can hurt me. It doesn't matter. You tell me when you're ready, okay?
Go, Giselle.
Okay, I got it. I got it. I got a number.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Okay, concentrate.
I'm nervous.
She actually is trying to fool us because she got the first number, the second one, and she's thinking now about number four, which is the total. Is that right?
Can you did you say the number was four?
Yeah. Is that number four?
I wasn't thinking of four.
Ooh.
Oh. So you think of four, or you were not thinking of a four?
You were right. I did jump numbers.
Oh, so she was trying to fool me. I told you guys.
Dang.
I told you guys, she was trying to fool us.
I was
fooling.
Why are you playing games?
I didn't mean to be playing games like that.
Damn.
Ooh.
So mean. She's even like her heart beat.
My heart is going. Stop reading everything. Oh my God.
No. I won't look around.
Oh sorry, I'm walking around right now because I can't.
No, she's sweating. No, it's all good. Like, even I show if you guys want to come. I'm gonna leave tickets so our people, they can write us on Facebook, social media. We're gonna get some tickets for our audience. And this is all about entertaining and having a good time, so you don't have to worry about anything. I'm just messing a little bit with you. She's actually very nervous.
I know, she's really
shaking, sweating.
That's crazy.
Thank you for being here today.
Thank you so much for showing that.
I
want to
learn. That wraps up our show for today. Thank you guys for watching.
If you want to keep up with us, I'm still shook. Be sure to follow us on our social media at Spotlight UNLV.
Tune in next time as we team up with KUNV as they host UNLV's very own music festival, Rep Fest. We'll see you then on Spotlight.